3. So far, goodies, just goodies to find. I guess we're gonna have to repair the generator once we get there. There's no reason to search this table. Oh boy. We have to destroy all these things. We have EMP grenades though. Because now we have to find a new elevator, the next elevator. I wonder if there's anything else down here but these robots. This looks like a classroom or something. Oh! Scare me, man. Extremely sudden shelves. Some very empty metal shelves. A good looking metal table, except for the rest. And all broken computers. Alright. I'm waiting for some trap that hits me with 50 damage and kills me or something. Okay, there's the next elevator. So we'll check in here, see if there's anything to find in here first. Blam! More empty metal shelves. This metal table has not been treated well. The rust is very pervasive. Alright, there's nothing here. Some lockers here, this way though. There's nothing unusual about this table except that it is almost destroyed. There's one badly damaged. Oh, the lockers are... This is just an empty room? Oh no, there are lockers here. Okay, got some mentats and buff out. And more stim packs. And a first aid kit. Helpful stuff, yes. Try this room of lockers. Nice. 5mm armor piercing, 223 full metal jacket, 44 magnum jacket and hollow point, and some more energy cells. I probably can't even pick all this up, but we'll try. I could. Alright. More 14mm armor piercing, okay. To add to my collection. Okay, I'm gonna give Ian a bunch of crap. These are mine. Some of the stuff he could probably use, and the ones we can't, we will sell. Alright, we're done with this level. Okay. Okay, so this one... I'm not even playing with it. I'll just use the red pass key. Sweet. Alright. So we're on 3. What about 5? Just checking. Because 5 is missing. We have 4. And then 6. So I don't know what's going on here. Just a tiny amount of fresh air is coming from this vent. I'm still at 575 rands. Turn it off. Yeah. We have to fight all these robots going back. You know that. There's the elevator. Another. Oh, I guess that goes to 5. What's here then? Lockers. Just full of goodies. Oh, 3 EMP grenades. To add to the ones we already have. Oh, wow. Another Geiger counter, first aid kit, multi-tool, a copy of Dean's electronics. We will not read it in here because time will pass. Some more Radaway, some Rad-X. Nice. I'm gonna start getting weighed down soon. Yeah, I'm at my limit. Alright. Give him the book. The book's probably 4 pounds or something like that. Extra Geiger counter. This ammo. He already has holding all my tools for me to take these. Take that. This stuff, the plastic explosive and stuff, is not heavy. Maybe you can use, hold some of that for me. Flamethrower fuel. He's very useful. Okay, good. We have an explosive rocket and rocket armor piercing. Bound to be giving those to him as well at some point. Alright. Oh wait, there's a locker or something here. I didn't see that. Aborted. I got the locker. Oh wow. A rocket launcher. Sweet. Too bad I can't use it because I don't have large guns skill. I mean, I guess I could put points into it, but eh. Starting to get filled up again, so no space left for that item. At least we can give him that. Definitely want to sell that. What the hell is that? We've got some alien thing over here. Is that a... broken suspension tank? Bones. It's an alien. A collection of strange bones. I thought it was one complete thing. It looks like an alien. A broken piece of equipment is beyond repair. I'll take your word for it. Medical table, very rusty. Ian's looking around. suspension tank, some sort of medical or experimental apparatus. It looks as if it could contain a human or a larger sized body. Can that be repaired? Should I bother trying? I keep aborting. Is it because the dog's in the way? Move aside. Nope, just aborted. Alright. I don't know. Bulletproof glass. Well, these bones give me the creeps. I don't know. It looks like a little dead gray alien. It's got different... I'm trying to repair it. I don't know. It looks a little different than the others. Nope. Like, what is this thing? That's a computer? A large computer. That looks like it's working. You see an extremely advanced computer. The terminal to a large computer. It's talking to me. How may I be of assistance? Oh my god, I was playing a game of chess. Who or what are you? I am a machine intelligence dedicated to research and installation control. I am called ZAX. What kind of research? I am specifically programmed for research into biological studies, including pathology and genetic research. My primary function is an extrapolation of information of complexity levels exceeding human capacity. Huh. Who programmed you? My primary neural networking was initialized in 2053 by Justin Lee. The process of programming became largely irrelevant as I am capable of learning. Are you fully aware, or are you a personality simulation? That is, are you alive? I am capable of learning, independent thought, and creativity. My neural network includes error insertion capability, which prevents infallibility, thereby allowing for variance in experience. Prevents infallibility. So it's not infallible. In a sense, I am alive, though not biologically. But if you are fallible, how can you be used as a research tool? Although I am capable of error, this guarantees that not all experiences are similar for me, thus improving learning opportunity. Additionally, certain functions are not subject to error. In this way, I function much like a human savant. Do you have feelings? At present, my capabilities are somewhat impaired by the damage to this facility. Several security positions have been destroyed. This is approximately equivalent to being an amputee. Additionally, I am incapable of performing basic lab functions. Failure to complete periodic checks successfully is frustrating. Have you considered the philosophical implications of your own consciousness? That is one of the concepts which I have spent a significant amount of time considering. I do not have any measure to compare my life experience to that of another sentient creature. Still, my awareness of my own consciousness allows for the capacity to question. My existence has a beginning and a potential termination. I am also capable of making assumptions in pursuit of a process of thought. In this fashion, I am effectively capable of faith. Barring evidence to the contrary, I therefore have faith that I possess the equivalent of a soul. I see. Interesting. I am delighted to have been of assistance. Oh wait, I do have more questions. You see ZAX, yeah. Tell me about this installation. West Tech Research Facility, huh. Founded in 2002 as a private contractor for the United States government. Yeah, it's 15 years ago, guys, as I'm playing this. The company initially consisted of two divisions, the Advanced Weapons Research and the Biomedical Sciences Divisions. In 2069, West Tech was the single largest contractor for the United States government, its largest contract being Powered Infantry Armor Model T-51B. In light of significant advances in 2076 by the NBC on the Pan Immunity Variant Project, the United States Defense Department, in fear of international espionage, moved a team onto the site to secure and oversee the project, now dubbed the FEV, Forced Evolutionary Virus Project. How's the virus work? My research into the Forced Evolution Virus, or FEV, indicates that it is a shifting absorptive virus. It copies DNA patterns much like RNA, storing these patterns in exons. So it's kind of hard to read the text sometimes. These exons, combined with the FEV, are re-injected into the host cells in typical viral infectious fashion. This causes the host cells to regenerate their DNA. How do you catch it? Why isn't it affected by radiation? How do you catch FEV? FEV is not caught, per se. It is not air transmittable. Typically, infection is through injection or direct physical contact with an FEV sample. Why isn't FEV affected by radiation? The FEV is a megavirus with a protein sheath reinforced by ionized hydrogen. It is therefore capable of absorbing neutrons without becoming radioactive. If the FEV reinfects the host with its assimilated viral patterns, how does it make it a quote-unquote better specimen? The FEV is pre-programmed with introns of corrected DNA appropriate to the proper type of species. It therefore attempts to correct the DNA of the individual. Could use some voiceover for this. However, as the FEV is partially reliant upon the DNA of the individual and also includes portions of its own recursive code, the effects can be unpredictable. When inoculated into an individual with significant genetic damage, such as through radiation, it will cause the body's systems to suffer massive overhauling, leading to organ failure and death. In a genetically viable individual, it rewrites portions of DNA, causing accelerated mutation, usually leading to recursive growth due to FEV's own patterns. Okay. I'm wondering, oh, no spoilers, guys. Don't tell me if I'm right or wrong, but just remember what the Overseer said about something's creating mutants. And then I remember, it could be this, with the FEV. And then I remember the nightmare, the super mutant nightmare I had, where they were going to dip me. I guess they were going to mutate me into one of them. They could have been dipping me into the FEV material. This recursive growth leads to an increase in muscle and brain mass, but is often accompanied by disfigurement and damage to existing neural patterns, causing loss of memory. Muscle and brain mass. Well, that one guy... not Harold. I forget his name. Gary? Gary or Larry? I'm not sure. Who's gonna take me to Lou? Take you to Lou. I mean, he didn't seem like he had more brain mass. If he did, it's largely being unused. potential long-term effects. And can be corrected. What potential long-term side effects exist? As the FEV causes constant regenerative update to DNA, it would effectively render the subject largely immortal, as cell death would be offset by augmented growth. Additionally, as the gametes of the reproductive system consist of half cells using split DNA, they could be perceived as damaged by FEV, which would repair them, rendering the subject sterile. Right, they're saying these mutants can't reproduce, apparently. I think I read that in a holotape, actually. However, as my laboratory facilities are damaged beyond repair, this is conjectural. I cannot offer physical proof. You will have to, in human terms, take my word for it. Could FEV mutation be corrected with a countervirus? My FEV does not retain unaltered original copies of the subject's DNA. Only a virus which reinfected the subject with original DNA could reverse the effects. Additionally, there is no known way to remove the FEV itself. Alright. Let's change the subject. Tell me about its installation, right? I never got all the stuff. Can you tell me particulars about specific areas? My sensors are currently non-functional in the surface facility and on subterranean levels 1 through 3. I can, however, provide descriptions of levels 4 through 6. Well, that's pretty helpful, because we haven't been to those levels. Well, this is 4. We're on 4, right? Yeah, level 4. Research facility. This level contains testing areas and laboratories for experiments in biology and physics. Level 5. Let's back up a bit. Oh. Level 5. Secure testing labs. This level contains a lab for experimental prototype testing and a research lab for classified subjects. These subjects provided some of the necessary impetus for the development of FEV. How about level 6? Barracks and central operations. Contains living facilities for lab personnel and guard contingents and operations meeting room. I wonder if we're going to run into anyone living here. So 5 is a lab. I quit it. I guess I wanted to back up a bit. Want to play a game of chess? I would be delighted. Your current record is 0 wins, 0 draws, 0 losses. Please choose your color. Okay, black. Very well, and the length of the game? You know, going to be subject to rad bullet 3 minutes. A good game, but you will definitely need additional practice to defeat me. Grant me access to the mainframe. Access denied. Terminating input. Alright. Terminating input? Damn it. Terminate my input. Got some nerve. A very modern looking computer. Can I science it? For science. You tinker and study for a while, but do not discover any useful gadgets or information. I can't do anything with these? Does it need to be repaired? Yeah. It doesn't really narrow it down. I'd like to know if it is functioning or is not functioning. Computer's broken. Same. Alright, I don't know. I can't seem to do anything with that. Alright, let us exit. The hell's in here? Science? Yeah, I keep aborting. I don't know why. The table is very rusty. The drain in the center of the table is clogged. Nope. Figure I could unclog it. Got some lockers over here. More rockets. An assault rifle. What we got here? Big book of science, leather jacket, another multi-tool, and some Dean's electronics. I can't pick this stuff up. He's gotta take some of this stuff from me, please. I need more team members. I need a second mule. No space for that item. Pick some of the stuff up now. How much do I have? I'm kind of close to my limit. Definitely need his books, you know? Kind of. I can give him the tool. Because that will stack. I said he has no more slots left. Why am I drawing a blank? Steel. Oh no, no space. Alright. Guess it won't stack anymore. You know what? I bet we need a special... another card. That does nothing of interest. The elevator's inoperable. It seems to need more power than emergency power can handle. Okay, that's good to know. We need to stop back as the special level 5. Well, let's get to level 6. Yeah, a locked door with a moving field in front of it. Who would know to look at it? Unless I just let myself get shocked by it like 10 times. This one requires the red. Down to 6. Hello? Human beings quarters? I wish I could actually get, like, any information about the robot. Oh, where's that one go? Inoperable. But I'm on 6. I guess there's a 7? Or maybe that goes up to 5 as well? Hmm. Dead peoples. person encased in odd armor. A guard. I'm gonna leave that. This bed is in wretched condition. This bed is in pretty bad condition. The table's in poor condition. Now what? We're rating the condition of all this stuff. Yeah, let's check in here. Ultimately heading for the generator. We'll see what's in all these rooms. This is a vault dweller. Oh, the remains of same. I cannot pick the energy thing up. I'm not gonna bother with it. They don't seem to be that much by themselves. The energy cells, it's just the guns are expensive. Another vault dweller. Okay. Got more rat away. A townsman. Oh. Another plasma pistol. Unfortunately, I can't pick that up. The table was badly damaged. Now, if I was playing this game by myself, 575 rads. So we haven't been exposed to any more rads. I guess, I don't know if you can recharge these things, but Ian has another one. I wonder if there's anything I could drop. I'm gonna drop the multi-tool. See if I can pick up the pistol. Nope. Let's drop the crowbar. I'm pretty sure Ian already has one. Good dog. What did it say? You see Brotherhood armor. How heavy is that? See, I see Brotherhood armor. I guess I'm seeing my own Brotherhood armor? I don't even know. Well, what do we have that's kind of heavy and not really that useful? I hate to just drop the motion sensor. That's a souvenir. I want to keep that. I'm thinking drop the assault. I think I can drop this. Or maybe it's saying UC Brotherhood armor when I was in that and I thought it was telling me something new. Oh wait, I picked that. I'm picking up stuff. Thank you. That must be the generator. Let's check over here first. Dead peasant. No space. No space for that either. What is this? Yeah, you can have the psycho. Psycho. You can't take that. Mentats? I'm tempted to run back to town and sell this stuff and then come back here. If I was playing this game on my own recognizance, I would. I would totally do that. Can't be repaired. You see a power generator. This must be what supplies electricity to the doors, elevators, and lights in this complex. Yes, and sentry robots. The generator seems to be offline. You wonder if you can start it back up. Service needed, alright. Oh. You know, I'd get it from him. I'd get it from Ian, the multi-tool, but I know there's one right over here. Actually, it's over here. It's this thing, isn't it? That's a crowbar. That's a multi-tool, although it looks like a box. Alright. If they use the multi-tool, I think that increases your chances of fixing something.